Hey everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Sabrina. I'm so excited to have you here today. I'm going to be talking about books I've thrifted lately. So before we get into this video, I just want to remind you that if you like this video, make sure you give it a really big thumbs up. Make sure you comment down below and tell me what one of these books sounds the most interesting, or if you've got any of these books, or if you've thrifted any books recently. Make sure you subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. I upload every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 2 p.m. Eastern time, and make sure you hit that little bell notification next to it to get notified every single time I upload. So without further ado, let's just get on into this. So I'm really big into thrifting. Everybody knows this. I spend a lot of time at Goodwill and the Salvation Army and smaller thrift shops, especially when you can find books. Books are so expensive, and especially when you can find recent reads, recent releases, or just popular books in the thrift store, it is amazing. So I do have the Salvation Army next to my college. It is about an hour away. It is about an hour away from where I live, but their books used to be 10 cents. They just upped it to a dollar, which is kind of mad, kind of crazy, but it's fine. And I just want to kind of show you what I found when I went the other day, because I just hit the jackpot, and I just want to share with you guys the books I found at Salvation Army, and then I have a couple from Goodwill as well, but I'll tell you how much I paid for them and all that stuff coming up. So let's just get right into the haul. So the first books I thrifted are The Kite Runner and A Thousand Splendid Suns by Khaled Husseini. Really hope I'm saying his last name right. Everybody says it differently, so I'm not sure how to say it. I found these books at Goodwill for a dollar for both of them. So I have actually The Kite Runner. I actually own this already, but it's an older copy, and this is the 10th anniversary edition, so it has this really pretty like goldy metallic-y look to it. I think I'm actually going to give away my other copy since I did get this one. I have not read it yet. I've heard it's very, very good, very heart-wrenching, and very emotional, so I'm really excited to actually be able to read it. I hear it's set in the Middle East, if I'm remembering correctly. Okay, and with the cover, I'm not sure, actually, so we'll find out. I've heard amazing things about this book, and I'm so excited to actually be able to read it, and this edition is just stunning. I'm excited. And then as for A Thousand Splendid Suns, there is nothing intriguing about this book. I actually did not own it yet, so I was actually excited to get it, and it's in really good quality. This is like Barnes & Noble shelf quality, which is super exciting, and I'm just really excited to be able to read it. I heard this is such a good sequel to The Kite Runner. I believe it's a sequel. I don't know. Maybe it's not. Maybe I'm just confused, but yes, I'm very excited. Now, as for the books I got from the Salvation Army, just so you're aware, all of the books I'm about to show you, the hard copies were $2 and the soft covers were two for a dollar. So I actually have most of them hard copies. I just hit the jackpot at Goodwill the other day in Salvation Army. I don't know how, because this never happens with books, but all of these are recent releases or they're popular books, which is what? So the first one I got is Masterminds by Cordin Corman. So this is a middle grade. I've been trying to get my niece into reading, so these are like perfect for her, especially because she is a middle grade reader. She is 9. And this book is set in Mexico, which I really like, because I don't see very many books set in Mexico and a middle grade at that. So I'm really excited for her to be able to read this, and I'm excited for me to read it, because if I like it, this would definitely be something I would incorporate in my classroom. The next one I got was Horton's Mysterious Mechanisms by Lisa Evans. So the main reason I picked this up was because this cover is just beautiful. It's like a paper like dust cover. I don't know, I thought it was really pretty, and it's really like, I don't know, it has deckled edges. It's just, and then the chapters, oh, there's pictures. Maybe I just got it because I think this book is super cute. I think this is a middle grade as well, but you know what, I just was excited for it because it was cute. I don't know if anyone's heard of this book, if you read this book. If you did, comment down below and let me know, because honestly, I've never heard of this book before I grabbed it at the Salvation Army, and oh, I love it. It's just so cute. So next I got is Perfect Little World by Kevin Wilson. This is actually a book of the month pick, which I was like, what? And honestly, I never hesitate when I say book of the month, just because they've never led me wrong. Every time I've got a book of the month book, I loved it. It was fantastic. So the synopsis for this says, when Isabel meets Dr. Preston, she's fresh out of high school, pregnant with her art teacher's baby, and totally on her own. Izzy knows she can be a good mother, but without money or relatives to help, she's still left searching. So I really think this is something that can hit home for a lot of people, especially with the single mother aspect and the young and pregnant aspect. So I'm really excited to be able to read this. I think it's going to open my eyes to a lot of the struggles that single moms go through, because you can only understand it so much if you're not a single mother. So I'm really hoping, I'm loving this. That's all I'm saying. The next book I got was Bad Romance by Heather Demetrius. So this book is about a girl who grows up in a very physical household, and her stepfather is very abusive, and she just needs a way out. So she meets this guy, and this guy starts dating her. He seems super sweet, but as soon as she moves out with him, he starts a little aggressive as well. And honestly, This is gonna sound horrible, but I really like books with abusive families just because they make for a very great story, and I think that's something that people can relate to one way or the other, especially with children who grew up in abusive homes. I think this is a way for them to see themselves in a book and see a happy ending. I think that's something that's amazing. So I'm really excited to read this. I'm hoping it's a happy ending, but cool. The next one I got is Behind Closed Doors by B.A. Parks. So this book is actually already on my shelf. I actually ordered it and I got a paperback copy for really cheap off ThriftBooks, but it's kind of beaten up. But I found this hardback in really good condition, like no bends or rips, for $2, and I was like, okay. So this is an abusive household as well. So like I said, I don't know what my deal is. I'm really excited to finally be able to read this. I have not read it yet, but I hear so many people talk about how amazing it is. I am part of a couple book groups on Facebook, and they all talk about how amazing this book is and how it opened their eyes to abusive households and what women go through, and I'm just excited. So the next one I got was Girls of the Moon by Janet McNally, which is also a book of the month pick. So as I said, book of the month never led me wrong. So honestly, when I see book of the month picks at Goodwill, I never even hesitate to pick them up. Never hesitate to pick them up. So I'm really excited to read this. I actually was eyeballing this for a book of the month add-on, but I was like, oh no, no, I don't need another add-on. I found it at Goodwill for $2, so am I mad about it? No. So I'm super excited to read this. I really hope it's as good as everyone says it is. It's about these girls who, like, they're very different, but in the same way, they're the same. I think that's, I don't know, I feel like everybody's like that. We're very different, but in some way, shape, or form, we are the same. And I'm really liking this aspect of this book. I'm really excited to finally read it. That's all I gotta say. Next, I got Ruth Ware, The Turn of the Key, and listen, this book is priced at $30 inside of the book. I got it for $2, and it is almost brand new. What? It still has the Target stickers on it. What? I'm really excited to read this book. Who did I hear talk about this book? Darling Desi, maybe? I think it was her. I heard her talk about this book and how amazing she liked it. I don't know. I've never read anything by Ruth Ware, but I hear so many mixed reviews on her, and some people love her and some people hate her, which honestly stresses me out a little bit when it comes to books, but what am I gonna do about it, right? So I'm really excited to give this book a shot and give Ruth Ware a shot. And this, like, foil cover is so pretty. I'm really excited to read it. I don't know. I'm really liking thrillers and, like, murderous thrillers. I'm trying to force my way through Mexican Gothic right now because I don't know if I'm liking it, but it's okay. So I'm really excited for this. I'm hoping that I like it. Next I got is the Raven Boys by Maggie Stiefer. I always say her name wrong, I'm sorry. But I already did own a copy of this book in paperback, but they had a hardcover for $2. So I might give one of these copies away. I'm not sure. When I hit 2,000 subscribers, I think I'm gonna do a giveaway. I'm at 1,600 right now. So if you're watching this and you would like to be considered for a giveaway, make sure you subscribe. I'm really excited to actually read this series. I haven't got to it. I know, I need to get my life together. But I'm really excited to finally be able to read it. It's gonna be great. The next book I got was Paper Towns by John Green. So I'm not a huge John Green fan. I'm gonna say it here so everybody knows. His characters are very bland. They're all kind of the same. The only reason I picked this up was because A, I haven't read it, and B, Nat Wolff is on the cover. And if you know who Nat Wolff is, you are the real MVP. If you know who he is, comment down below and tell me, because we're gonna be buds. The next one I got was The Host by Stephenie Meyer. So I've never read this book, and if you have not seen my Twilight reading blog, I'm not impressed with Stephenie Meyer's writing. But I heard this was better from a few people, so I have the fingers crossed. Well, this is also available Twilight, New Moon, and Eclipse, so maybe this is before Breaking Dawn, but I don't know. I'm hoping it's good. I don't like this cover though. I don't like the cover. But yes, I'm really hoping that I like this. A lot of people have said it's good, but I've heard mixed, it's just like Twilight. You always hear mixed reviews about Stephenie Meyer, so the lighting got really dark all of a sudden. Do you see how dark the lighting got? I'm hoping I like it, fingers crossed. The lighting just got dark. Hopefully I can fix it in editing. I don't know. So the next one I got is A Girl Like That. So I've actually heard really good things about this book. I cannot remember who I heard talking about it, but they said it was so good, and especially like stories on like self-discovery and like finding yourself, and this sounds like one of those. Next I got The Sun Is Also a Star by Nicole Yoon. So I normally don't pick up books without dust covers at the thrift store, but I did with this one, for the exception of I don't have this book. If I ever find this book again, I'll probably get it if it has a dust cover. But I've heard this book was really, really good, and I'm really hoping that I like it. I heard Haley and Bookland a long time ago talk about how amazing it was, so fingers crossed that I like it, because I don't know. Next, I got The Young World by Chris Wentz. So this is a post-apocalyptic story, and that's something I've been liking as well. After a mysterious sickness wipes out the rest of the population, the young survivors assemble into a tightly run tribe. Jefferson, the reluctant leader of the Washington Square tribe, and Donna, the girl he's secretly in love with, have carved out a precarious existence among the chaos. But when a fellow tribe member discovers a clue that may hold a cure for the sickness, five teens set out on a life-altering road trip, exchanging gunfire with enemy gangs, escaping cults and militias, and braving the wilds of the subway, all in order to save humankind. Maybe this is a little touchy for what we're going through right now with COVID, but I don't know. I just feel like this is bound to happen one day where a sickness wipes us all out and we all like go into like this apocalyptic world. The only people that are gonna survive are people that know how to wear their mask. Next, I have The Woman in the Window by AJ Finn. So I've heard really good things about this book as well, and this was $2, like brand new book almost. $2, people. I'm really excited to read this book. I've heard it was so good, and I've been really liking thrillers lately. I don't know what my dealio is, but I'm really excited to read this book. I'm hoping it's as good as everyone says it is. My fingers and my toes are crossed. I've really been liking thrillers, and I hear a lot of people say his writing is kind of like Riley Sager, and I've been obsessed with him lately, as you guys know. So I'm really, really hoping I like it. Fingers crossed. Next, I got Is Brain on Fire by Susanna Callahan. So if you guys have not seen the movie, there's actually a movie about this on Netflix that is a Netflix original about a girl with this mysterious brain illness that's like causing her to go through all these episodes. And I'm really excited to read this. I think it's a documentary on her, like, or it's a memoir. Yeah, it's a memoir. So yes, it's a memoir. So I'm so excited to read it. And finally, I have The Sea of Trolls by Nancy Farmer. So I've been really, really, really enjoying fantasy lately. So this is a fantasy about a guy who gets captive by Vikings. What is this lady doing on this video? I don't know. But Vikings, trolls, I don't know. Sea war. Okay, let me in on it. All right, that is gonna bring this video to an end. I really hope you guys enjoyed it and enjoyed seeing all of my thrifted finds. I really do enjoy thrifting books, especially when you can find ones as good as this. If you guys like this video, make sure you give it a super big thumbs up. Make sure you comment down below and tell me if you bought any of these books, what books you find while you're thrifting, or if you're planning on getting any of these books. If you like this video, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below for more videos like this. I upload every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 2 p.m. Eastern time. And make sure you hit the little bell notification next to it to get notified every single time I upload. As usual, I hope you guys are having a great day, a great year, and a great life. And I will see you guys in my next one. Goodbye!